down deeper on near the town of Dungannon. There many's a ruckian myself had a hand in. Bob Williams left there a weaver by trade, and all of us dubbed him the bold morning blade. On the 12th of July, as around it would come, Bob played his flute to the sound of the drum. You can talk off your harp, your piano, your lute, nothing compared to the Isle of East Blue. Bob the deceiver, he took us all in. He married a papish named Bridie McGinn, turned papish himself and pursued the old call that give us our freedom, religion, and law. Now some of the boys made their comments upon us, and Bob had to flee to the province of Connaught. He took his wife and his fixings to the boot, and along with the laughter his alarming flew. At a chapel on Sunday to atone for past deeds, Bob said his prayer while he counted his beads. Till after some time at it, priest on desire, Bob took his flute for to play in the choir. Bob took his flute for to play there in mass. The instrument shivered and said, "Kiss my ass." And bow as he may, though it made a strange noise, the flute only played the Protestant boys. At a council of priests that was held the next day, they decided to ban the flute away. They could not heresy out of its head, so they bought Bob a new flute to play there instead. The flute was burnt and Bob was quite sick, was fastened and burnt as another day. As the flame roared around it, we heard a strange noise. The flute was playing the proudest boys. As Bob played there dying, he heard a strange noise. The flute was playing the Protestant boy. Burned at the stake as an altar pick. It was no wonder that I was sick. The Protestant boys, the Protestant boys, the flute just played the Protestant boys.